Hi guys! In this video, I'm going to be talking about dissolving filler and what to expect. Okay, so as you know, most of the fillers being used today are hyaluronic acid filler. So if you have a hyaluronic acid filler and you'd like to dissolve it, we have an enzyme called hyaluronidase. What hyaluronidase does is it breaks down filler. So for example, if you have lips, you had hyaluronic acid filler and you don't like it anymore, you can go and get it dissolved. So basically how the process would go is you would experience pretty much similar side effects as you would with filler. So swelling, bruising, redness, you're gonna be poked a few times. You're not gonna have so much the sensation of like product going in, but it's gonna instantly break down the filler. Your injector is gonna feel it and see it instantly break down, but then you're gonna have swelling right after. So you might not see the results right away, but it works over the course 24 to 48 hours. And then you're just left with some swelling, which can take, you know, a few days to kind of subside. And the bruising is gone. If you had any, then you're left with your virgin lips. Most people end up perfectly fine and back to their regular lips within a week, but some people may require multiple sessions. Typically, I like to do it all in one sitting and get everything out, but some injectors choose to be more conservative about it and inject over a couple sessions. Now I want to touch on some common misconceptions about hyaluronidase, which is the dissolver. Is it safe? Yes, it is pretty much safe. I would say to date, I've never had any issues with it whatsoever. The risk of anything going wrong is quite low. So yes, it is a safe drug. And then typically people say that they heard or they saw somewhere that when you put the hyaluronidase, it also dissolves your native hyaluronic acid, meaning the hyaluronic acid already present in your skin, because hyaluronic acid is present in our skin. It's what gives it that plumpness. And what I have to say to that is there are no studies or, you know, real papers to suggest that hyaluronidase dissolves your native hyaluronic acid. That said, even if it did, you wouldn't really notice it. And our bodies are constantly replenishing our hyaluronic acid in the skin. So even if it did hypothetically, it would probably be temporary. Another thing people say is that after dissolving, they actually look worse than their before photo. I find that typically this is extremely rare for it to be fully true. I don't deny that some people do feel like they look worse, but there's a couple factors that I think are important to consider if you dissolve filler and then you feel like you look worse than before you had the filler. Number one is, how old were you before you initially got the filler? And I find that actually this complaint is mostly with the under eye area. Tear trough is a very high risk area, very tricky. I feel like it's one of those areas that people come back to dissolve often after lips, just because it is an advanced technique and it can be hard to get it absolutely right. I'm very selective with my candidates when it comes to tear trough filler because I do believe in some people it can make them look worse. Anyway, so it's one of those areas that tends to get dissolved and then people sometimes feel like they look worse. But things to consider is A, how old were you before you got the filler and how old are you now? If there's a 5-10 year gap, chances are it's just natural aging, and around the eyes is one of those areas that ages the most rapidly, I find, despite doing treatment. So even if it was just 1 year that you had the filler, you may get some extra wrinkles here and there and think after the fillers dissolve,
oh my God, like I didn't have this little wrinkling, my skin texture wasn't like that.
The truth is, it's probably aging, it's probably sun damage or other factors like that. And the second thing is, I truly do believe that people forget what they used to look like. They get filler and then they see their before photos and they're like, oh my God, like I used to look like that. People forget, they see their improvements and then that's their new baseline in their head. So even if the under eye filler was poorly placed, it still creates a plumpness and irons out some wrinkles. So you may think, oh my God, I look worse with the filler, and then you dissolve it and then you're like, oh wait, now I'm sunken in, my under eye is sunken in worse than before. But that's not usually the case. The case is typically that you were sunken in and then you got filler, but then it looked worse because the filler was either too puffy or whatever else, or you got tindling, and then you dissolve the filler, but you fail to realize that despite the tindling meaning the bluish tinge some people have underneath their eye after getting tear trough filler. Despite the tindaling, it still created a support for the under eye. I feel like that's probably why the under eye is the trickiest area when it comes to dissolving. And people are always concerned about that area because they feel like it's gonna end up looking worse. Now, if you dissolve your under eye and you feel like your under eye is just, it's not looking okay, it's not looking healthy or whatever, then I would recommend doing some PRP injections or some type of laser resurfacing. Now, despite saying all that, I will never deny someone who tells me that they look worse after dissolving because everyone's anatomy is different. Everyone feels differently about their face. So I would never deny someone that truly believes that they look worse after dissolving. So it's something to keep in mind that you may feel like you look worse beforehand. Again, this is rare, but it's just something to consider. Now, another common thing people ask when we're talking about dissolving filler is, should I dissolve my filler? And that's one thing that's 100% your decision. If you don't like the filler and you want to dissolve it, and it's been at least 2 weeks since you got the filler, then you can dissolve it. If you hate the filler, please dissolve it. I know so many people, they come after like 2-3 years of having filler that they didn't like. I'm like, you held on to that for that long? Like, you could have dissolved it. If you hate the filler, don't be scared. Dissolving doesn't hurt more than getting filler. That's another misconception, actually. People think it hurts more, but it doesn't. I would never want any of my clients walking around with filler in their face that they don't like. Always come back and get it dissolved. So that is it for my video on dissolving. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment and I will answer all the questions. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.